Hi, welcome to the Shtick. We're committed on the Shtick to make the world a better place. And the people who are right at the top of the tree, who have got a real Shtick happening, are a group called Stand Up. And the CEO of Stand Up is right here with me in the studio, Gary Samowitz.
How are you, Henry?
Samo.
Good to see you, mate. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, thank you. You've been on before. But you used to be on as somebody who was involved with Jewish Aid once upon a time. What's the evolution? It was before that it was Keshet.
Yeah, it's actually our 21st birthday this year. So we were Keshet from 1994 to 2004, mm-hmm. and then we became Jewish Aid from 2004 to 2014. But we decided to change our name last year, mainly because there was a lot of confusion with Jewish Care. When people heard the name Jewish Aid, they thought, you guys aid the Jewish community. When that's not quite what we do. We're all about getting the Jewish community to make a positive difference in the world and engage wider society. So we love our new name. You know, it's a call to action, getting the community to stand up and make a difference, not be bystanders.
Yeah, because the Shtick is a mad show, you know that.
Yes.
We're mad because we're here to help people understand that there are people around like you who are committed to making a difference. And that's what MAD stands for. You've got a lot of programs going which you are really involved in. Name me the top one that's really important for you at the moment.
So we obviously do a lot of work with Sudanese refugees and indigenous communities. We're also doing heaps of education programs. So we work in all the Jewish day schools running innovative social justice education programs. We have a program called Stand Up ABC for 11 and 12 year olds. That's like social justice 101. What is poverty? Who am I responsible to? How can I make a positive difference in the world? And we've also launched The Fellowship, which is a leadership program for Jewish young adults aged 22 to 32. Mm-hmm. And it's a 10-month course, 12 workshops, 4 excursions, 2 retreats. So it's like almost like a master's in social entrepreneurship through a Jewish lens. And it's an investment in the next generation of our Jewish leaders. So that's a program I'm really excited by, Stand Up Fellowship. Because I think all these programs are instilling a sense of social justice and community responsibility in our young Jews, which will long-term have a really positive effect on where our community is heading.
Because it's all about education. I really believe underlying everything, in as far as our next generation is concerned, you're educating them how to be a mensch. And we know what a mensch is, don't we? A mensch is a person who knows how to do the right thing. It's all about doing the right thing within your own sphere and within your family, and then looking outward into your community and then the world. So it's a responsibility we have as a human being to be a mensch. And that's what you're developing in our young people.
Yeah. And in order to become a mensch, you need to be grateful for what you have and you need to be humble.
Yeah.
So those are some of the values we're trying to instill in the next generation of Jewish leaders. But yeah, you could call us a mensch factory. Maybe that should be our tagline.
I like it.
But yeah, we're also working a lot with the Sudanese refugee community. We've been doing that for 10 years, running homework clubs, women's groups. We have a program called ICAN, where we work with the year 10s, 11s and 12s, Sudanese kids every Sunday. Mm-hmm. We get the best tutors from the Jewish community to work one-on-one with these kids with their schoolwork. Mm-hmm. But we've also built a 3-month leadership and personal development program. So the strong culture of youth leadership that we have in our community, the Hubbo, the Orges, all these great institutions, we're exporting that model of youth leadership to the Sudanese community and also the indigenous communities we work in. So that program's called ICAN. We took 15 Sudanese kids away on a retreat 3 weeks ago.
Where did you go?
We went to Camp Aspie Downs, just an hour and a half out of Melbourne.
Camp Aspie. It's beautiful.
Yeah, and it was like exploring what are my goals, what do I value, what is our culture, and how can we make a positive difference. So we're doing pretty exciting stuff in that space.
And did they learn about the environment as well? Do you have an environmental branch as well in, you know, going out to the country and you making them aware of, you know?
They did a tiul, they did a hike. Yeah. So they explored nature. But Stand Up as an organization, we've decided to focus on being a humanitarian organization that focuses on people, empowering people, connecting people. So we don't do a lot of work around animals and environment. But of course, all those issues are linked.
Yeah.
If you want to make a better world, you can't ignore cruelty towards animals and the degradation of environment. But most of it, we deal with human rights and not being a bystander when there's injustices happening.
And you have an award, the Ron Caston Award, that you give every year.
Yeah, we wanted to celebrate Jewish Australians doing great stuff in the humanitarian space. And there are so many of them. So we decided to create the Ron Kasten Humanitarian Award to recognize and celebrate members of our community who are out there doing some fantastic stuff for the wider community. Dr. Howard Goldenberg won the first award 2 years ago.
We had him on last year, the Jewish Writers Festival.
Yeah, he's a great man, very humble man. And Dr. Hilton Immerman from Sydney won it last year.
Uh-huh.
But we also have a young Ron Kasten Humanitarian Award. So someone under 30 who's doing great stuff. They're starting their journey of social change making, and they get an award.
And who won that? I know the name.
Jackie Lipson won it the first year.
That's right.
And Jenna Radnan won it last year. So we're really proud. We have a beautiful evening with the Kasten families there, and the people who won the award give a speech to tell us a little bit about what they do.
Mm-hmm. Just in case no one knows who Ron Kasten was, he was very much, he was a lawyer, and he had a very big involvement in the Mabo decision, didn't he? He was really working with the Indigenous community to get the whole thing happening. And there is a Ron Kasten Human Rights Department at Monash University.
That's right. And Ron Kasten, a proud Jewish Australian who did so much for Indigenous Australians. And really, that was a big part of his identity. I'm living in Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Surely I have a role to play as an Australian and a global citizen to empower the first Australian. So he's a great mentor and role model to us. He passed away 15 years ago, unfortunately.
I remember.
But the values that he had, being a humble man, not interested in the limelight, just making a positive impact. And that's exactly what he did. So we want to recognize the other Ron Kastens out there.
Fantastic. Well, that's what we're working on all the time in our community, is to get people to be more aware of how they can make a difference and change the world for the better.
Yeah, and we, as an organisation, have 200 volunteers.
Wow.
Aged 12 to 85.
200?
Yeah.
That is fantastic.
That's how we're able to do all our programs. We only have equivalent to 8 full-time staff. So all the work in Indigenous communities that we're doing, and we have 60 volunteers every week working with Sudanese refugees.
Mm-hmm.
So we're really proud of that fact, that most of our programs are driven and led by volunteers.
Fantastic. Well, it's really wonderful to have you on the show. And we're coming back with Lillian Klein, who is also involved with this wonderful stand-up organization, to tell us about their fantastic Passover project, which is the Australian Haggadah.
Yes, the new Australian Haggadah.
Which is amazing. As soon as I saw that, I went, wow, I've got to do something about this, because Passover is coming up next week on the Friday, and Pesach and Good Friday are coming up on the same day.
That's right.
With a red moon.
Really?
It's very eerie. So we'll be back with Lillian Klein talking about Passover, Haggadah, Good Friday, and the red moon rising.
Cool.
Thanks very much, Sam.
Good to see you, Henry.